Let's compare diagnostic versus formative versus summative. How are they similar? And how are they different? So, why should you implement each assessment? Diagnostic assessments will inform teachers of student achievement gaps and other academic abilities. Formative assessments will help teachers recognize when students are stuck during instruction. Summative assessments will measure whether a student has mastered a large quantity of material. When should you implement each assessment? Well, diagnostics are often given the first day of class, mostly before starting a course or a new unit. Formative assessments are administered directly during the teaching process, and summative assessments are given last, at the end of the unit or the end of the period of course. What are some examples of each assessment? Diagnostics can usually be found in the course textbook. Texts usually have pre-course tests. Formative assessments can be as simple as using student questioning techniques. And a summative example can be a class thesis paper. Next, how should you use each assessment? Diagnostic assessments can be used to plan future lessons and to differentiate students into groups. Formative assessments are best used to make teaching decisions on the fly. Should I keep explaining or should I move on? Summative assessments should be used to judge whether or not a student can advance through a course. Right now, I would just like to say thank you for your time, and please subscribe to this channel. Thank you very much.